and it is good. And so with just a handful of seconds gone here in the second quarter, thanks to a 35-yard pass, Fasani to Powell and the PAT, Stanford leads 14-0. Trojans will have it when play resumes. 14-0 in favor of the Cardinals. We'll be back. 14-0 in favor of Stanford, and they'll be kicking off now to the Trojans. Arbet and Ledoux, the two deep men for SC. Powell has really had a big time of the ball game so far. You can see that was only 34 yards. Fasani hit him with the pass for the touchdown, but he caught that 45-yarder from midfield that took the ball down to the five, where Carter then went in to score. He's caught two balls, 84 yards, and of course a touchdown. Rideau's got it near the goal line. Back to the 15. Needs a block, can't get it. Down he goes at the 20-yard line. SC will take over just shy of its own 20. Call it first and 10 at the 18-yard line. Total yardage. SC with 67. Pass over the middle, complete. Up over the 30 to the 31, and that's good for a first down. And Kerry Colbert makes the catch and makes it first and 10 SC at the Trojan 31-yard line. Well, SC's had some chances in this early going, but opportunistic Stanford with gifted athletes and a quarterback who makes the big play just when you've got to have the big play has pretty much dictated this first half so far. We're in the second period. 14-0, the handoff to McCullough, looking for somewhere to go, and finally has to settle for a short gain to the 35. Going to be a pickup of about four, and he ran into a lot of people, not the least of which is big number 92, Hoover, an outside linebacker for the Cardinal.
I think this drive is really important to USC. Do you see how quiet it is here? This is your home field advantage. This is really important for Carson Palmer in this offense. Make something happen on this drive.
Second down and six for the Trojans. He's in a shotgun formation, the aforementioned Mr. Palmer. Back to throw, has some time, now gets rushed, has it tipped away as the offensive line broke down, and big number 92, and that of course would be Hoover again. And big number 89 was right, 98, Scharf was in on top of him. A lot of people just shoved that Trojan offensive line out of the way. Watch the pressure that Palmer suddenly has coming from his left.
That was big Matt Leonard, number 99, 6'4", 290-pound senior from Palmdale, overrunning the USC offensive line.
Going to make it third down, put the ball at the 35, and it's third and six. Palmer needs a big play now. He's trailing 14-0 out of the shotgun. Big rush. Throws it. Too high. Had his intended receiver, Kareem Kelly, at the 40. I tell you, Palmer was lucky to get that away without losing an arm. What a rush up the middle.
That was Tank Williams, a free safety. Free safety blitz, number 13, and that caused the high throw. Palmer had the right idea, but Tank Williams saved the day for the old Stanford Cardinal.
And
watch
he had
Tank Williams.
He had to throw it too quick. Watch. There's Williams right in his face. Got nailed as he let it go, and Kelly couldn't get high enough to pull it down. SC in a kicking situation. McGillivray hit a beauty, 44 yards the first time. He's standing at his own 21. Pretty good rush. Gets it away and hits another dandy. Fair catch is signaled for and taken by Powell at the Cardinal 22-yard line. What a great kick by McGillivray. And that one's 43 yards. And the Cardinal will start at its own 22-yard line. They lead 14-0. Last year, McCullough had a career-like day, Craig Purdy.
Boy, he sure did. He put on a show up there on the farm. Palmer shows you his speed there on the old keeper.
And then came Chris Lewis, a Southern Californian, who throws the ball with no time left on the clock, and Stanford goes away with a victory. SC rallied from a big deficit only to lose. Stanford first down in their own 22. Stanford's won the last two in a row and three of the last five. That squirming, battling his way to the 25-yard line is Carter, brought down by Prosser.
Look at the stats last year, huh? How even can that football game get, huh?
And look at the time of possession. Stanford had it almost 20 minutes more than the Trojans. Plays almost double, huh?
Big plays by the Trojans in that one. And unfortunately, the big play was on Stanford's side right at the end.
Gain of three, second and seven, thanks to Carter's hard effort. 14 to nothing, Stanford. Asani, the quarterback, has the back split. Back to throw and has a ton of time. Firing it long downfield, going for all of it. Incomplete. The pass was intended downfield for Bowman. And defensively, the Trojans had Cash along with Simmons right there.
Excellent coverage by Chris Cash. Boy, that's a young defensive back at home. If you're watching this, and watch how he gets into the inside pocket of the wide receiver here. Still looking back at the football. Great body position. Get your hands up. Boy, that's picture perfect right there. That's technique.
It ends up at a third and seven for Stanford at their 25-yard line. Trojan defense will be asked to stymie Fasani now. He's been able to come up with big third down conversions. Gets a rush, throws it in the flat. Catching it is the tight end, and that'd be Pearson. He's dropped short of the first down as Pollard makes the tackle at about the 31-yard line, and a lot of blitz pressure on the quarterback, yet he's still got it away, Craig.
Safety blitz, and Fasani saw it, went to the right guy, his tight end, Pearson. You know, this past summertime, a good friend of mine, Larry Brown's the personnel director of the Houston Texans. They'll be the new entry in the NFL. He had me looking at all the quarterbacks in the country, and Fasani, I'm telling you, that guy is a number one draft choice. Boy, has he improved.
I said that to Bob Murphy. I didn't say he was number one. I just said, what a great pro prospect. And Murphy, who's been around Stanford and San Jose State, the Bay Area so long, they may name a bridge after him. I don't know. At any rate, he said, no, I don't think he's consistent enough. And he said, he's only 60% completions. I said,
only?
I said to Murphy, when'd you get so particular, Murph? Beautiful punt, Johnson. It's taken by Rideau, slips it. It's our bet. Takes it back up over the 30 to about the 31-yard line, where SC will put it in play there. First and 10 at their own 31. 14 to nothing. Stanford leads. We'll be back. So the Trojans will take over on their own 31-yard line, trailing 14 to nothing. Stanford has really had the big play to their advantage here in this first half. Barry, what's happening on the sidelines?
All right, guys, we talked about Sultan McCullough needing a big game for USC to do well offensively, but much like Oregon last week, Stanford has taken the run away from USC. McCullough's carried it six times, minus 1 yard, and a fumble. Has to improve for USC to get it going.
Palmer, 7 of 13, throws it in the flat, 8 of 14, passes caught and wrestled down as he crosses the 35 was Kareem Kelly. Tried to get him out there one-on-one, and they did, but he couldn't get away. Going to be a pickup of 6. Call it 2nd and 4 at the Trojan 36. Call it 2nd and 5.
I think that's a good first down call. Ryan Fernandez, the cornerback on that side, is playing off of Kelly about 8 to 9 yards. And boy, on first down, get 6 yards now. Come up with a 2nd and 4.
Goldberg, who's caught 3 balls, is flanked to the south or open side of the field. Palmer dumps it off. Well, he's lucky that wasn't intercepted, or was it? Yes, it was. Picked off by Fernandez. I don't know who Palmer was going to throw that ball to, but he threw it right at a white shirt. And the defensive cornerback, Fernandez, number 7, came right up and scooped that ball right off the ground.
I think he's looking to the out pattern. He saw that was covered. He took something off the ball. He was trying to dump the ball to McCullough. You can see the trajectory of the football. He's trying to throw that ball to McCullough. He's not trying to throw the out. That ball could have been tipped at the line of scrimmage, but I don't think so.
So Fernandez comes up with the interception. That's his first of the year. He's a senior out of Richmond County. And the Cardinal now with a 1st and 10 at the Trojan 40-yard line. Hand off to the tailback. Finds some running room, slips a couple of tackles, and is down inside the 35. As he gets to about the 33-yard line, and that, of course, would be Allen, tipped up by Palomalu. It's going to be 2nd down and about 4 after a gain of 6.
Going back to the interception, Tom, I think he was trying to come back to a quick out pattern to Tom, or to Kareem Kelly, not Tom Kelly. Yep. Tom Kelly is my receiving partner up here. And Fernandez, the corner closed on it. He tried to take something off it and throw it to McCullough.
Allen, the lone setback behind the line of scrimmage as Fasani with a long count pitches back. And he's hit and dropped for a loss, coming in very, very quickly for the Trojans. Number 94, Udizi, but there's a flag down, and SC might have been guilty of offside. Excuse me, 48 yards in penalties and 79 yards in total offense.
said something about shooting yourself in the foot earlier, didn't he?
It's about in the knee, maybe even in the upper leg. Back to throw for Sonny. Fires, got a man wide open at the 2-yard line. With the grab is Johnson. And Fasani now has had 3 very big passes completed. One for 45 yards that led to a touchdown. One of 35 yards that was a touchdown. And now this one, he throws from the Trojan 30 to the 2-yard line. And one would assume it now will lead to a touchdown. It's going to be first and goal, Stanford at the Trojan 2. They already lead 14-0.
They catch the Trojans in a 3-deep zone and run their big split in the seam in that zone between the corner and the safety.
Fasani is, I think it looked like shooting ducks in a barrel, a fish in a barrel, to give to Carter, and he is stacked up for no gain. Call it second and goal, leave it at the 2-yard line. Fasani has started 10 career games and is 7-3. And while doing that, winning 7 or playing in those 10 games, is averaging almost 33 points. He's missed 3, and Stanford's 0-3.
We'll call him a winner. Look for him to keep the football down here. When he was a sophomore, he was their goal line quarterback. They loved the running down here.
Second and goal at the Trojan 2. Stanford looking to take a 3-TD advantage. Fasani rolling, throws in the back of the end zone. Nobody there but a Cardinal. The toss, the completion, and Stanford now, as Pierce makes that grab, has taken a 20-0 lead.
Well-designed play. You release 2 tight ends out, one in the flat, one in the deep corner of the end zone, and he has the option to throw short, long, or run the football. He elected to throw it long.
Here's another look at it as Fasani rolls out in beautiful protection, and all alone at the back of the end zone is the big tight end. That is his 10th touchdown toss of the year. No interceptions. Fasani to try the extra point despite a rather bad snap, good handle. He kicks it through, and just that easily, after taking over on the Trojan 40-yard line, following the interception, Stanford puts it in the end zone. 21-0. Here's another look at it.
Play action pass. You run your tight end into the flat, your fullback into the flat, and your other tight end goes deep to the corner, and there's Pierce, as you said, for the 10th touchdown pass of the year for Fasani. And the part I like, Thomas, no interception.
None whatsoever. And from the way he's performing today, this is going to be probably as easy a ball game as he'll ever play. Pierce has caught 2 passes from Fasani, this one being for a touchdown. Prior to that, he did not have a touchdown catch. He's caught 2 balls today. So Fasani is having just a brilliant day. 7 of 11, 143 yards, and 2 touchdowns. Doesn't get much better than that. We're somewhere along in the second quarter. The clock's not working. I can't tell you exactly how much time is left. That kickoff goes out of bounds inside the 5. That'll bring it out to the 35. First and 10 for SC at its own 35-yard line. Stanford continues to use the big play and the brilliance of Fasani to dominate this game. Palmer gets a rush, dumps it out, it's caught complete. At the 42, up to the 44-yard line. Pass is caught by Sonny Bird, reserve fullback. And they'll mark him at about the 44, going to be a gain of 8, called it 2nd and 2 at the 44.
Well, obviously Stanford with a 21-point lead is playing a zone defense in a very soft zone, so Palmer ran crossing patterns with his wide receivers and then snuck his reserve fullback, Sonny Bird, up underneath those linebackers.
Well, in the ensuing minutes, about 8 now remaining in this first half, it would be good if the Trojans could find some way to get on the board. That was Howard, a freshman tailback, got the handoff from Palmer and got back to the 44-yard line for no gain. So it's going to be 3rd and 2 at the 44. And the Trojans in the Pac-10 in scoring, 15.3 points a game. 48 in their first 3 games. Hands off, and it's Howard again and again. He can't get the 2 yards for the first down. Stymied and turned away, so it's going to be 4th and 2. Well, You know, if this was the last play of the half, I might say so, but there's 7 minutes to go in this first half. And Fasani has been brilliant. Palmer kept it. Depends on where they mark it. You going to give it to him?
I'm going to give it to him with my not as keen eye as yours, but I'm going to give it to him.
I tell you, I hesitated, didn't I?
You did. Just a little hitch in the giddle.
But he's 6'4", and if he just managed to fall ahead, they're going to move the chains to the delight of a partisan USC crowd, and it'll be first down at the Trojan 45. Barry, what's happening?
All right, well, the Trojans do appreciate Craig giving them that first down. They were 0 for 2 so far this year on fourth down conversions, including that one earlier in the game. Finally got one. Hopefully this will get something going for them.
Well, they certainly need to, quote, get something going for them. They're down 21 to nothing. We're almost through the first half. Palmer throws it out in the flat, complete to Kelly, trying to break away but can't. Fernandez grabs him, and I tell you, Fernandez was like a dog with a bone in his mouth. He wasn't going to let Kelly go. Kelly did manage by hook or crook to get up over the midfield stripe to the Stanford 49, which is going to be a gain of 6. It'll be 2nd and 4. Kelly never worked harder for 6 yards in his life.
Well, that's a good recovery by Fernandez. You notice he's giving Kelly that pretty good cushion, but that's an excellent open field tackle by Ryan Fernandez, the senior out of Skyline High School in Oakland, California.
He just would not let go. So it is 2nd down, call it 4, a long 4. The Trojans trailing 21 to nothing, have the ball on the Stanford 49. Palmer keeps it, gonna run with it. Not very far, shoved out of bounds for a loss back at his own 49.
He's used that quite a bit last week against Oregon. Obviously Stanford has studied those tapes.
Palmer to throw, dumps it, it is tipped at the line and incomplete. Tried to get it to Corey Dickerson, but it was incomplete after being tipped at the line, and so
big
not trying to get anywhere with this fourth down as you watch Palmer's pass attempt get tipped at the line of scrimmage. They'll send in McGillivray to kick it. Going back is Powell, fine punt returner. In fact, he's been averaging, coming into this ball game, no less than 33 yards every time he returns. He's pacing at the 10. McGillivray hits it again, a high hanger, turning over. Out of bounds. We'll wait and see where the officials are going to mark it. Coming up to about the 24, 25, 25-yard line. 21-0 Stanford. We'll be back. 21-0 in favor of Stanford. Randy Fasani, the 5-year senior at quarterback, has been every bit as good as advertised. Here's his first one, 45 yards to Powell. That sets up a 4-yard run by Carter. Here he is again. And again he goes to Powell. Then he throws it to Pierce in the end zone. He's been sensational.
Murphy says he can only throw for 60%, huh?
Yeah. Well, nobody's proof. Stanford at its own 25. Fasani hands off to his tailback. Still on his feet, Carter spins to about the 29-yard line. Going to make it a gain of 3, 2nd and 7 at the 28-yard line. 21 to nothing. Pierce has a touchdown. Carter a touchdown. Fasani turns, hands to his tailback, big hole, and he's up over the 35 to about the 38-yard line before he's brought down. Moore, the fullback on that carry.
Well, it's a trap play to the fullback, Casey Moore. Good call by Bill Dietrich, the offensive coordinator at Stanford, been around a long time. They put their tailback Carter in motion, stretch the SC defense. When you trap a rushing defense like USC, it slows down that pass rush on Fasani.
So he's got receivers wide to the right side, 21 to nothing. Fasani has the ball at his own 37. Straightens after a short down, a drop, throws, completes it to about the 44. And Powell is the man who catches it over there in front of Richard.
Look at the career starts on that offensive front line of Stanford. You know, if you want experience on your football team, that's where you want to have it, is your offensive line. These guys have been together for 3 years. They have to work as a unit, and they're sure showing it here today.
Second and three after a gain of 7 on that little short pass in the flat. Asani turns, hands it to his tailback. Carter slipped one tackle. Strong was in the backfield, couldn't get him right away, but when he spun around, Frank stayed with him.
And offensive line, conversely, on the other side of the ball, SC has a lot of young people on that defensive line.
Asani with the third down, straight back to throw. Has time, throws it over the middle, incomplete. Tried to get it downfield at the 42-yard line. A pass intended for Wells, knocked away, incomplete, and Stanford will have to kick.
Another good play by Chris Cash that time, number 29, the corner on that side. Watch Cash, number 29. They tried to burn him on the outside earlier, and he played that one well. This time they run a post pattern. Watch Cash, just picture perfect. Reach over with that left hand, and obviously the ball was thrown high, and he didn't have to swat it away, but he was in position to do so.
Johnson back to kick. He had a low, bad snap that he fumbled the last time. The punt was, or the try was blocked. He's back, standing at his own 30, gets it away, hits a high beauty. Waiting for it for the Trojans. It's taken, no fair catch, grabbed by our bet, and he brings it back to the 26-yard line. Check the scoreboard clock, 3 minutes remaining in the first half.
Three timeouts for the Trojans.
SC, first and 10 at its own 25. McCullough can't get outside. Remains second and 10. Fasani has been brilliant, coming up with big play after big play. And the Trojans have been unable to do anything in the way of putting it on the board. Palmer to throw. Fires the pass. Oh, almost intercepted. Hernandez almost had that one. Kerry Colbert was the intended receiver. Palmer's 10 of 19. He's got 95 yards, intercepted once. Back to throw, third down, steps away, dumps it off, pass complete. At the 40, at 45, at midfield, and Landrigan is on a race, but I don't think he'll get to the end zone. Fernandez brings him down at about, they say he stepped out close to the 13-yard line, and Charlie just kind of ran out of gas in the lieu of Fernandez chasing him. Where are they going to mark him down? The 11-yard line, that'll be first and 10 at that point.
Great job escaping the rush by Carson Palmer. Once again, that same play that he connected with Bird earlier, the reserve fullback. The linebackers got depth that time. He dumped it underneath to Charlie Landrigan, and old rigor mortis set in about the 20-yard line on old Charlie.
62 yards overall. It's been the best play the Trojans have had one way or the other.
And I see Kent Baer, the defensive coordinator of Stanford, getting his troops together and say, let's go after the goal line defense, man. Now watch Palmer here. Watch him get back here and move his feet. Watch him move his feet by himself some time. Here comes the receiver right across his face. He outruns Gabriel, number 52. Pretty good move on the strong safety right there. Now, come on, Charlie, put it in that second gear. Boy, I tell you, Ryan Fernandez, number 7. You see him trying to punch that ball out at the end. He's playing one whale of a football game for the Cardinal at right corner.
He came all the way across the field to make that catch and to point up the other bit of athleticism on this Stanford team. After Gabriel was out of the play, he kept chasing him down the field and nearly got him on the second try. So Palmer comes on the field now with a first and 10 at the Cardinal 11. 2 minutes remaining in this first half. Pitts goes in motion. Palmer gives it to McCullough at the 10. Gets nowhere. Coy Wire came up, met him first. He was also met there by number 42, Carter, the cornerback.
I was going to say the corner opposite Fernandez on the other side, Reuben Carter. He made a good play coming up and forcing it back into Coy Wire.
Try as he might. You can see that he's carried it 8 times, minus 1. Thank you, Michael. There's McCullough trying to go outside, trying to run away from somebody. Gets dropped inside the 10 at the 9. He tried but could not get away as the Cardinal defenders, Hobson, number 90, was over there. Awfully big and awfully quick. And number 15 coming over as well was Taylor, a reserve cornerback. And they've got it at the 9-yard line. It's going to be 3rd and 8 at the 9. And time now down to 51 seconds as Palmer brings him to the line of scrimmage. Stanford defense appears so tough, you think they've got 12 guys out there. That was almost intercepted by Wire. They tried a little flanker screen, Craig, and it just was right behind the receiver and almost into Wire's mitt. Now he's got a 26-yard try to get SC on the board. Line is set, it's down, he hits it. It is a low driving one that is good. So the Trojans come up empty. So Davis, after hitting three a week ago, he was 3 for 4 for the year. Now is 3 for 5, and the Trojans come away empty. So it'll be Stanford first and 10 at their 20-yard line. 3 for 5 in the field goal department. He was 3 of 3 a week ago. Missed one in the game against Kansas State, as you recall. Time remaining, half a minute. Officials stop the clock.
It was a beautiful day there in Corn Valley.
I understand it was, but 75 degrees or what have you. And Fasani's just going to touch it down. And so the first half is going to come to a close for Trojan fans and their faithful. It couldn't quit and stop too soon. The Trojans unable to do anything with the football and missing one golden opportunity to put something on the board. Randy Fasani to Powell, a 34-yard reception for the touchdown. He had hit Powell for 45 yards to set up the first one. And then he came back and threw it in the end zone to Pierce for the third touchdown of the afternoon for the Cardinal. Rideau wait for the ball at or near the 5 and the goal line. The ball is in the air, out of the shadows, into the sunshine. Our bet at the 5. Across the field is hit, spun down. He'll be short of the 20. It'll be at about the 18-yard line where SC will take over. First and 10. Call it the 19, 21 to nothing, Stanford. Carson Palmer in the first half, thanks to a 62-yard toss and run by Charlie Landrigan, came up with 158 yards. That's 11 of 21, intercepted once. That is more yardage than Fasani had throwing, but of course it resulted in the Trojans getting to the 9-yard line and no further, and unable to score. First down. Over it in motion, the pitch to McCullough, going to try to run it. Looking, throws back, gets a block, needs another big one, can't find it, gets a little bit, and turns nothing into a pickup of 7 or 8 yards, takes it out to about the 27.
Actually did get another block, Tom. The
Carson
quarterback.
Palmer. Yes. The quarterback threw one. Here's McCullough again. Watches, there's no room there at all.
Watch him come back to the weak side now. Now watch old number 3 down the field here. Big Carson Palmer right there from blocking Coy Wire.
Only picked a guy more his size than one of those big defensive ends.
Nobody ever said his mama raised a stupid one.
Second and 3 at about the 26-yard line. Palmer throws it out in the flat. And no gain. Caught out there and spun around and dropped almost in his tracks.
I would expect the Trojans, they had such success last week with that spread, no huddle offense. I think they need to have some kind of a momentum changer or something to shake that offense loose.
That was Stevenson, and I think they generously are giving him a yard to the 27, which will make it third down and a bona fide 2, maybe 2.5. Over it in motion, McCullough. Berry. Dropped by Coy Wire and number 45, Hodari, the safety, who just came from nowhere to be right on top of McCullough. So the ground game continues to do nothing, and the Trojans are 3 and out and into a kicking situation to a team that is enjoying a 21 to nothing advantage. Powell waits for the ball at the Cardinal 33-yard line. McGillivray, who has kicked the ball well today, gets it away, a low squibbler that bounces at midfield, takes a Trojan bounce, rolling inside the 40, 35, and is shepherded down to about the 33-yard line. All in all, not a bad kick, all things considered. But Barry LeBrock on the sidelines as the Cardinal will take over. 42-yard punt, no return. Barry, what's up?
Well, how do you play football with a 21-point lead at halftime? If you're Ty Willingham, just the same way you played in the first half. I asked if he'd try to run some clock here. He said, no, just play football. I asked if he'd soften up the zone a little bit. He said, same thing we got going in the first half. for lack of a better word, accused him of having a softer zone at the end of the first half. He said absolutely not true.
So Fasani up under center now. His team leads at 21-0. Straightens to throw right over the midline. Almost intercepted. Pollard had it. Couldn't hang on at the 40-yard line. And what a big play that might have been for